Hey, John Cristani here, internet marketer and tech entrepreneur, and I'm really excited to talk about somebody who's been pretty influential in stuff I've been doing lately, the man, the myth, the personal finance guru, Graham Stephan. Now, if you've been following this guy, let me know in the comments below. He's an amazing person. He's got a large YouTube following. He talks about personal finance items, how to save money and whatnot, and I've been learning a lot from him, and I'm gonna go over these four different lessons that I've learned from Graham Stephan in this video. So I hope you learned something from this and keep watching. John Cristani here, and I'm a YouTuber, but Graham Stephan's also another YouTuber, and I've been watching his videos a lot lately. Let me know if you do watch his videos as well in the comments. He loves cars. He also lives in Los Angeles like I do. He does real estate and very smart about finances, and I'm gonna be going over four different lessons I've learned from Graham, and without further ado, let's get into his videos. So the first thing I've learned from him is be consistent, and I'm just gonna underline that again. Be consistent. Graham has consistently been uploading for years on his YouTube channel, 3 videos a week, and it's helped him grow even when his channel was not making him much money at all. Even when his channel was making him $0 and he was running a successful real estate practice, he kept uploading. He kept up with consistency. He's not dabbling in YouTube. He went all out and he focused a lot on quality, which I'll talk about in a little bit. But I've seen this consistency, and I see this amongst other successful entrepreneurs. I watch what they do, not always what they say, and from what Graham does, he is incredibly, incredibly consistent. Now, lesson number two that I've learned from Graham is to be transparent. Throughout all of Graham's stuff, I've seen just incredible transparency. Personal finances and how much money you spend, how much money you earn, all of that stuff is something people don't like to talk about. That's the reason why there's a lot of misinformation about how to save money or what to do with your finances. From what I've seen of Graham, he really breaks down people's numbers, his own expenses he goes over, even goes into his personal life, putting his girlfriend on camera and what have you. My wife doesn't want to be involved in my YouTube channel. I get a lot of weird messages, but he's just incredibly transparent, and I think that's really warming, and I think that's what people want to see. In fact, I know that's what people want to see here on YouTube. So this is another big lesson I've learned from him, and his channel has grown a lot as a result. There's just monster amount of trust, right? Transparency breeds trust, and I really like this about him. Lesson number three that I've learned from Graham Stephan is be professional. Now, this is something that's been kind of new to me, but I've been very unprofessional in just my approach to social media. Even look at me now, right? I'm wearing like a Porsche hat and I'm wearing jeans and stuff, but this is something I'm starting to decide to focus more on. His level of professionalness has really taken him to different heights. He's been interviewed on CNBC, he's been interviewed on Forbes, he's in all of this major press, and he's also attracted a wide variety of people because he takes his profession so seriously. Now, I teach marketing, which is slightly different than personal finance, but at the same token, I think I could probably be a little more professional in just the way I dress, the way I look. I like doing my hair this way. Maybe I'll wear more hats, I don't know. But let me know in the comments below if you think that I should keep it casual or be more professional. Type in the comments below. I think I definitely need to up the game there, and I think it just helps business. And the fourth lesson I've learned from Graham, which is to be cheap. Graham is so incredibly cheap. Type down below, cheap nation, or just be cheap if you understand where I'm coming from, because this guy spends 20 cents on his coffee. I make just about as much as Graham Stephan does every year, if not more, but I spend a lot more money. I spend 20 bucks on my coffee sometimes. I'm not even joking. I've never really focused on being cheap, but this is a wake-up call. How he treats his business, how much money he socks away, and I put away a lot of my income into retirement accounts, but I could do better. I could do more. I could push it. You know, I live in a nice house. I don't actually live in a duplex like him and save every single penny. But I think we can learn a lot from this, is that money is a scarce resource and we've got to put as much of it away as possible. All of these consumer items that were really marketed, most of them we don't need. I don't need to spend $20 on coffee. I don't need to spend $100 on a meal. Being cheaper is definitely a way to put more money away into your family's retirement account and take care of your family. So let me know what you thought of this video. This is a new format for me. Let me know if you like this format where I go over what I learned from people that I learn from and who I model. Graham's an amazing guy, and I definitely suggest you check out his channel. I'll plug his channel somewhere at the end of this video. And also let me know in the comments below what lessons spoke to you the most. Being consistent, being cheap, being professional, etc. So let me know in the comments and make sure you subscribe to my channel and like this video if you want to see more marketing content, because on this channel I just go over everything marketing. My goal is to help you create your own home based business and make money passively from the internet. So subscribe to this channel to see more videos about that. Thanks for watching.